Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam is having a dialogue and a discussion and a meeting with Abu Bakr and Umar radiyallahu anhum. It's the late hours of the night, the early hours of the morning. As they conclude the discussion and they exit, in the distance they see a young man is engaged in nocturnal prayer. And he's just conversing with his creator. May Allah give us that beauty. May Allah give us that pleasure. We could sit on the phones, we could sit on the net, we could peruse unsavory sites, and the hours would run by and the days would go by, and we would be oblivious of our responsibility. And these people could sit and converse with the creator, and he was unaware of the surroundings around him, and this man is just praying away. And the Prophet ﷺ comes up and he sits behind him and he listens, and then he whispers to Abu Bakr and Umar, man sarrahu an yaqra al-Qur'an ratban kama nazal falyaqra'hu ala qira'ati ibn ummi 'abd. If you really want to read the Quran as it was revealed to me, this is the man you want to mimic. This is the man you want to follow. And who was this? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. And he has no clue who's behind him. And he's just praying on and praying on. And tatajafa junubuhum, tatajafa junubuhum anil madaji'i yad'una rabbahum khawfan wa tama'a wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqoon. That the pious, when they go to sleep, we get up for a call of nature. We get up for a different need. They become restless while sleeping. I need to talk to my creator. And they disturb. Tatajafa, tatabaad. They move up, they stand up, and they converse and they communicate. And he's praying away, and then he's making dua. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying from the rear, sal tu'ta. Pray, I'm saying ameen. You ask, ask, ask along, I'm saying ameen. And he doesn't know, and he's just praying and praying, and he's supplicating. And the messenger says, can you probably imagine? My brain freezes. You're not sitting only in the holy lands. The paragon of Allah's creation, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is behind you and saying, ameen, ameen. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Umar says, we just green with envy. Like, this is now, you know what, this is a jackpot. This is a lottery at its best. This is good fortune falling in your lap. It can get better than this. And in my heart, I was so happy for my brother. Abdullah Sayyidina Abu Bakr said, I decided. And this is another dimension of the life of Abu Bakr. How many of us are those that would engage in prayer? We would engage in activities, but our hearts are not clean for our next Muslim brother. We would sit here together, but we will plot and connive against one another. هَذَا زَمَانٌ لَيْسَ إِخْوَانُهُ بِإِخْوَانِي إِخْوَانُهُ كُلُّهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لَهُمْ لِسَانَانِ وَوَجْهَانِ يَلْقَاكَ بِالْبِشْرِ وَفِي قَلْبِهِ دَاءٌ يُوَارِيهِ بِكِتْمَانِ حَتَّى إِذَا مَا غِبْتَ عَنْ عَيْنَيْهِ رَمَاكَ بِالزُّورِ وَبُهْتَانِ هَذَا زَمَانٌ هَكَذَا أَهْلُ بِالْوُدِّ لَمْ يَصْدُقَ إِثْنَانِ. سيدنا علي رضي الله عنه said, هَذَا زَمَانٌ لَيْسَ إِخْوَانُهُ بِإِخْوَانِ. Tragically, we live in a time where brothers are no longer brothers. How much do you want to expect from friends? لَهُمْ لِسَانَانِ وَوَجْهَانِ. He's got two tongues and two faces. يَلْقَاكَ بِالْبَشْرِ. He meets you with a smile. وَفِي قَلْبِهِ دَاءٌ يُوَارِيهِ بِكِتْمَانِ. But in his heart there is a flame that's burning. حَتَّى إِذَا مَا غِبْتَ عَنْ عَيْنَيْهِ رَمَاكَ بِالزُّورِ وَبُهْتَانِ. And you step out of the gathering, and then he hurls the most nasty comments about you. He's evil, he's wicked, he's nasty, he's like this. But just look at the balance of Abu Bakr, and that's what I'm saying. We take in one virtue to a super level, and on the other level we just failing, and we just dropping, and we just declining and degenerating. But Abu Bakr was this epitome of perfection on all fronts. And he said, I decided in my heart, I'm happy for my brother. I'm so happy. In the morning, Umar radiallahu anhu said, I'm going to run to the door of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. I get up with a dedicated agenda, and I come and I knock on the door of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and he opens, and my face is beaming, and he's, what's the excitement, Umar? I said, Ibn Mas'ud, can I tell you something? Go for it, my brother. You know, last night you were praying. Yeah, of course. You know, you were supplicating Allah. Alhamdulillah. Do you know what? Tell me. There was the Prophet behind you, and he was endorsing your prayers. He was sanctioning your requests. He was affirming your concerns. So I just came to give you the good news. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is not moved, and he's not impressed. So Umar says, and why? He says, Abu Bakr was here before me, before you. He's informed me already. Wallahi ma sabaqtu Abu Bakr ila khairin qattu illa sabaqani ilay. Umar said, this was the one time in my life I thought I'm going to excel Abu Bakr. And what I'm going to say is, I'm going to try. I couldn't compare with him when it came to charity. I couldn't compare with him when it came to helping the creation. But I said, let me be one ahead of him in trying to be happy on the achievements of others. So I said, I'm going to go first to the house of Ibn Mas'ud. But when I got there, he says, no, Abu Bakr was here before you. But anyway, I appreciate you came and told me. Jazakallah. But Abu Bakr was here in the morning and he came and congratulated me. Allahu Akbar. That indeed was the spirit of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu.